keep it real simple, keep it real simple. Bring everything right back to ground zero, cause it all comes down to this. Love God and love people. We live in a world that keeps breaking, but if we wanna find a way to change it, it all comes down to this. Love God and love people.
Simple Church is known for a lot of different things. Hopefully, more importantly than anything else, it is about what Christ calls us to. It's not just something cool to do. It really is about, God, what do you call us to do? And he always asks us to go outside our comfort zone a little bit and make sure that we meet the needs of people everywhere, wherever they are, but particularly in our city. You know as well as I do, there's been a lot of tragedy over these last few months, but particularly for the Simple Church, we had a pretty rough week this week. So as I told you to download the app and you pull up on those notes, and if you look at those notes, at the very beginning, I tell you, I ask you to check any one of these events that apply to your life. For example, you see traumatic event. If you go, man, that is me, that is my family, I can relate. This past week, we had a tragedy where we had a loss of life that none of us were prepared for. And in that battle and in that struggle, we were called into the middle of working with our first responders and listening to the needs and the hurts of people in our community. But I want you to know that I can check that one right off the bat. A strained relationship. Maybe by some weird chance you go, man, that's me. I came here to try to get my mind off of it, but there's a relationship that's not going great. A serious health problem, crushing disappointment, unchangeable circumstance, or a painful loss. These are just some of the things that I personally have gone through or seen one of my friends go through just in 1 week. Just in 1 week. And so I thought about this as I was preparing this message today. What can I say to all of us today? What can I say to you to encourage you? What can I say to you to remind you that we're going to be all right, that we're going to get through it? The first thing that I would say is the Bible is absolutely clear that life is hard. Can I get an amen on that? You see it in your notes. Jesus told us to be this in John 16:33. He said, in this world, you will have trouble. And let me tell you something, man. I promise you, we have had our share. We even got news this morning as I'm getting ready to get on stage. We had a tragic loss of a young man's life traveling back from East Texas last night on his football team. And I'm thinking, okay, Lord, man, we need you. We got to have you. We need some help because we are seeing moment by moment, day by day, that life really is hard. But here's the good news. God tells us that, hey, it's going to be tough, that it is going to be hard. But he also tells us that he's going to give us help. Can I get an amen on the help side of things? And let me tell you why this is so important. Is I need to know I'm not in this thing alone. And as you look around, you will see some faces you know, maybe some faces you don't know. But I want to remind you that God tells us not only do we have the people around us, and we will talk about that in a moment, we can lean on and depend on him. In John 16:33, it continues when it says, I told you these things so that you can have peace in me. The reason that he wants us to know that there's going to be trouble in the world is so that we would lean on him, because he will give us the peace that we need. And in this world, we want you to be brave. I'm going to be honest, when the stuff starts happening, you have a tendency to get fearful. You have a tendency to kind of want to back down and go, I don't know how we're going to get through it. But he ends telling you, I have defeated this world. And what is he saying? Trust me. I'm going to be here to help you. When life is hard, I promise you, I'm not going to leave you. Romans 12:2 says this, do not allow this world to mold you into its own image. Instead, be transformed from the inside out by renewing your mind. Now, I'm going to be straight with you. I'm a pastor. I've been in ministry for a long time now, 30 years. I can tell you this right here can get you. You start letting things get in your mind and you start seeing everything that's going on. The next thing you know, you can begin to convince yourself, I don't think it's ever going to get better. I don't know how we're going to get through this. This is the worst of the worst. And if this preacher struggles with it, I can promise you, I know you have too. That's why I have to go back and say, God, help me renew my mind. Help me, God, not to focus on everything that I see, but help me to trust you. And as a result of renewing my mind, I will be able to discern what God's will is and whatever God finds good and pleasing and complete. I can put my mind on those things. I don't know if it applies to you today or not, but if you're like me, you check one or multiple things at the beginning of this lesson. And this to me is what I have to do on a daily basis. This morning right before I left, me and my wife have been kind of walking through some family stuff, and it's been kind of heavy. And I looked at the scripture and I wrote down a scripture and I sent it to you this morning as we were leaving, saying, hey, listen, I know it's easy in everything that's going on to let it overwhelm you, because I feel the same thing. But let's run to Him and let's think on what is good and pleasing and complete, and renew our mind and trust God that He can transform us. I can't do it on my own. I got to have Him to be able to help me get through it. And how does He do that? You'll see it right there in Psalm 119. If you got your little app open, you can see the notes. You don't have to fill in. All you got to do is look at it. Psalm, by your words, I can see where I'm going. They throw a beam of light on my dark path. Let me tell you why that's important. Everybody's trying to figure out how to make it through everything that's happened in this past year and a half, maybe in your own life in the past few hours. God's word promises to light us and give us hope and give us direction. And when everything seems to be out of control, you have to learn how to go to God's word and say, God, help me. I need to look at your word, because you feel a million miles away. But His word is as close as your phone. You can download the app. You can download a Bible app. You can look at the notes. Why do we put the notes online? So that you can have something to lean on and go back to get through whatever you're going through. And then this is the third and final thing I want to tell you. When I start thinking about life being hard, and I know that God gives us help, I can tell you the part that I really got to work on is that we have a choice of how we respond. You and I can choose a lot of different ways when things start happening, whether it's a tragic event, a strained relationship, all of those things I told you about. But this is the one I sent my wife this morning. You ready? This is found in Psalm 94:19. My challenge to you is to avoid thinking the worst. When everything starts happening, we all have a tendency to go to the worst case scenario. Oh my gosh, I don't know how we'll ever get out of this. I don't know what it's going to look like. And then I read across this scripture in Psalm 94:19. Lord, when doubts fill my mind, this could be your career. This could be your job. This could be your health. This could be your relationship that looks like it's failing. This could be anything. This could be a tragic event that you've gone to. God, when doubts begin to fill my mind, when my heart is in turmoil, this week I saw family after family in very difficult circumstances. Turmoil was there. It says this, quiet me, God, and give me a renewed hope and cheer. God, let me be able to be quiet and renew my hope and renew my cheer, because my mind is running. My mind is going on all these things, and I'm thinking about everything that could go wrong, career-wise or finances-wise or relationship-wise or health-wise. God, give me a renewed hope and cheer. The second thing that I'll tell you how it works for me is obviously reaching out to Him, looking at His word, and saying, God, I'm putting this in my front of me. Sometimes I put these scriptures on my dashboard. Why? Because every time I'm driving and I'm speeding and a first responder's pulling me up, no, I'm just kidding. Because when I look, I like to make sure that it's right in front of me. Because if it's not in front of me, it gets out of my mind. So I try to put it in front of me. But there's another way, and that is through the people around you. When we went through this tragic event on Monday, one of our band members, one of our kids that grew up in the student ministry, his wife tragically took her life on Monday. She took her life just a few blocks away from here, and in the midst of everything going on, the band that you see up here fighting through and pushing through, it's been a rough week. They could have easily said, man, I ain't gonna make it today. I'm just gonna let it just go on out. I'm out. But what I love about when I got to the scene on Monday is I saw friends rallying around friends. I saw people that were willing to run to the mess, not away from it. So many times, man, when things are jacked up, everybody wants to just run away. You want to hide. You want to just kind of get alone. What I love about the men and women on this stage, what I love about the Simple Church, we're not perfect. We got a lot of things that we're working through. We ain't got it right. But let me tell you something. You cannot do life alone. You will see right there on the page, a friend is always a friend. And relatives are born to share our troubles. If you think you can get through what you're going through by yourself, you are wrong. I can't do it. No one can do it. So the only way to do that is to say, hey, man, I'm struggling. Hey, man, I need your help. Listen, it ain't about necessarily calling me, although I'd be glad to help any way that I could. It is many times you don't realize the power of your encouraging words. You don't realize the power of your presence. When stuff is going on and you show up or you send a text or you make a phone call, you never know how God that in someone's life. But I'll tell you how. I'll give you a reminder. I did a wedding last night. I'm out in Hill Country. Beautiful. Jason Blake, Grace Ann, little Maggie's getting married. She's been in Simple Church since she was 8 years old. We're celebrating her wedding. It's a great night. Everybody's having a good time. And me and Jason graduated Southwood together around the same time. We're laughing and cutting up, having a good time. It's an awesome night. But friends are coming together to celebrate this moment. In the middle of everything that was going on, I'm getting ready to say bye. I'm saying, hey, 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 hey. Someone from the Willis Knight Hospital System walks up to me. Right in the middle of all the wedding, the middle of everything going on, and she begins to get a little teary-eyed. She said, Justin, I want to tell you something. You'll never, ever know really the impact your church has had on the hospital and all of our employees. I said, oh, like we all do. I'm playing off, man, it's our honor. She said, no, you listen to me. She said, we had a tragic event in our hospital system. The first nurse in the Willis Knight system that died because of COVID happened just a few short weeks ago. They had been dealing with tragedy with everyone else week after week, month after month. Now, almost 2 years. But she said, but when that happened, Brian Reed showed up, Christy Rose, Jessica Brock showed up, and you know what we did when they showed up? They came to sing in the hospital. They came to pray with them. They came to just be a friend. Say, hey man, I got you. So why does it matter today? Some of you come down, you're going, well, wait to get out of the house and eat some good rebel food. That ain't a bad thing. But what you're about to do in a few short minutes is be a friend to someone who may not have a friend. Some of you gave gift cards, your money. Maybe one nurse or one first responder comes by this week and opens that, reads your note. Think through what you write on that page. This little card that we're going to give you. Because what I learned last night is it matters. Churches get hung up in a lot of junk that don't matter. And what the Simple Church is trying to do is be a real problem solver in the name of Christ. The last thing we want to be known for is stirring up stuff, creating problems, creating division. Saying we know better than someone else or our ways better than someone else, that's not who we are, man. What we've been known for and what we will be known for is being a brother to those that need a brother. Loving on people that are hurting. Taking time out of your schedule to make sure we tell them how important they are. And today matters. It matters a whole lot. Galatians 6:2 says, carry each other's burdens, and in this way, you fulfill the law of Christ. People, some of us going, how many times y'all going to keep talking about first responders, doctors, nurses, and all that kind of stuff? Let me tell you why. Because they're carrying a burden that you and I aren't carrying. And if you, for just a little bit, if I can just for a little bit, can help them carry that burden, I'm telling you, Christ is honored, and his law is fulfilled. And as I get ready to wrap up, I want to remind you, I apologize for being a little emotional because it's been one of them weeks, y'all. And I tell y'all every week, I ain't preaching to y'all, I'm preaching to me. This is what I'm having to lean on. This is what I have to remind myself of. And what I will remind you of is that we can make it and we will make it. How are we going to do that, Justin? Because we serve a God that says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. That's not just Evander Holyfield's boxing shorts. That's legit. It applies to you and to me. It applies to whatever you brought underneath this pavilion or whatever you're holding in your heart or whatever box you checked. Whatever you don't want to talk about, whatever you're afraid that somebody else will know, he says, I can get you through this. Psalm 34:18, the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. If you came out here and you're fighting through it and you're that close to feel like you're being crushed, he says, man, I got you. I see my boy Philip over there and I think about his dad and I think about how his heart was to build St. Jude homes for all these kids that were broken, that needed that encouragement to raise money. Why? Because it wasn't about him. Let me tell you something. If you think it doesn't matter when we lost a great man like that from this earth and gained him in heaven, he would tell you, he'd tell Phil, he'd tell every one of us, you still have a job to do. Don't look down on yourself. Think about what you can do. Think about what you can give. Think about your purpose on this planet, because this world needs you. And what we're about to do is, when you're making these little notes, it's something as simple as that. I got my life group guys here, and they're the worst sinners there are. I promise. Y'all stand up. No, I'm just kidding. They already know. But what we talk about and what they want more than anything else, it's like, man, I need to know that I'm making a difference, that it matters, that my life counts. We talk about doing projects and drilling water wells and helping people. And here's the reason why. Because in that moment, you can realize you can change the world. You can make a difference for someone. I'm challenging you. Don't miss this opportunity today. Don't rush through writing the note. You may never build a St. Jude home. That's not your skill set. But you can, through your words, encourage someone that desperately needs it. And maybe someone will be put in your path this week that you're going to run across. And you'll be tempted to be busy and go through. And all of a sudden, God will say, this is your person you should encourage. This is your person you should talk to. I got one other buddy right now. His name's Brian Hutchinson. We call him Starsky. And the reason I love Brian is we went to Southwood together as well, but he's battling cancer. And instead of just sitting in his battle of cancer, he did what most of us probably wouldn't do, but we should and we're encouraged to do. He said, man, I'm going to find some way to start serving and helping other people in the midst of everything I'm going through. So just last week, he even did. He was a BMX guy back in the day. Man, we all, that's talking about Vans. It goes a long way back, son. All right, so we were all riding, wearing Vans, riding bikes, and having all that fun time. But let me tell you something. He took all of that tragedy, all that difficulty he's going through, and he raised money to help kids and families that are still battling. Whatever you're going through, don't you give up. Find some way to do good. Find some way to point people to Christ. Find some way to say, hey, we're going to make it. He can and will get through this. Katie Franks, little Dakota, this coming Saturday, she's going to have her little birthday party. And guess why she's going to have that birthday party? To raise money for other families of childhood cancer. What's the Simple Church about? Why are we trying to tell you what to do? Why are we trying to lead you in what to do? It's because every time we do it, it reminds people of the hope that is found in Christ, and it gives you purpose. It gives you a reason to get up. And look around, many of you did today. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for getting up. Thank you for believing us. Thank you for giving. Thank you for being a light in the darkness. I'll give you one last verse. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Will trouble, or hardship, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or fight, dangers, or swords? No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Through him who loved us, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels or demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is found in Christ Jesus. The reason I put this verse in here is because when you start going through the tragic loss of someone taking their life, when you go through tragic circumstances, we had a murder in Blanchard that we were all just tragically rocked by. We have a child that dies in a car accident last night. You think about it, every day it just seems like it's just hitting you. You and I got to be reminded, what will separate us from the love of Christ? Nothing. Nothing can separate us. So I encourage you today, lean into his word. Pull these notes up, pull them up, look at them again, and go, no, I ain't going out like that. I got to get my mind right. I got to focus on the right thing. Because last week, I reminded you of Revelation 21. He will wipe away all of our tears from our eyes, and there will be no more death, no more sorrow, no more crying, no more pain, because all of this will be gone forever. Anybody want that soon now? Anybody can feel me? I can feel Lane, I see you back there. Let me tell you why, because this world, it is tough. But the reason I said, as I said last week, you're still here, is because today God's going to use you. You got a purpose for being here. Thank you. Use that card. If you want to make a donation, you can do it online. We're not going to take any of that money from the Simple Church. We will raise this money and give it to these doctors, nurses, first responders. Y'all know how we work. It ain't about money for us. It's about helping other people. So if you want to do that, or if you have a business that you want to donate something, please feel free to say, I want to do something to help. I was eating at Zaxby's because I'm a health nut and I love great food. Steve comes up to Watkins, who tragically lost his daughter in a car accident with Brian, Molly, back years ago. And I said, Steve, we're doing something for doctors, nurses, and first responders. He owns the Bossier Zaxby's. Steve said, I got you. Here's 200 free meals for anybody in that. said, Steve, I'm not asking for that. He's like, no, man, that's it. Now, y'all be like, Steve Haley. Why do I tell you about like a guy like, you know, Steve Watkins? It's because everybody has something you can do, and don't miss your opportunity. In the last bit of the notes here, you will see a bunch of one another's, about 50. Some of my favorites on here is I thought we'd go ahead and do about number 18 to 19. Let's greet each other with a holy kiss, my favorite. I'm just kidding, man. That's a joke. There's a whole list of different things that you can do. But down here, what I looked at, and one of my favorites is found in 1 Thessalonians. It's just a reminder to keep encouraging each other. I want to tell you, your emails matter. Debbie, your gifts matter. Your phone calls matter. Your texts matter. Because I'm telling you, it matters to me. In the same way, I'm telling you, do that for one another. And let's do that for these first responders, these nurses, and these doctors, and all of these people who do it for us. One last little shout out. I see Mr. Ellis here. He would be embarrassed if I bring him up, but he's just another business owner that every time we need something and every time we call for, hey, we got to try to help somebody, he's like, man, whatever I can do. And I want to just tell you this, talk's cheap. A lot of people say they're going to do whatever, but there are people that go do it. I'm in it. Tragically, we could not find a concrete bench anywhere in the world due to COVID. We were going to build a beautiful mosaic bench so that we can have it down there at that end, but nobody could have a concrete bench. And that's the reason I say this is you walk through and you're going down to our booth that Robin will tell you about here in a minute, you're going to see these mosaic benches on either side of you. They've been a tradition forever down the Revel. And all I can think about while I was preparing this message and thinking about all that was going on is that there is brokenness, but there can be beauty in that brokenness. And so as you begin to think through all of the brokenness and all the things that are going on, let's ask God to reveal himself through us, through our giving, through our sacrifices, so that people can begin to see the beauty in loving each other, accepting each other, taking care of each other. And from the bottom of my heart today, I tell you, thank you for doing that for us. Thank you for not giving up. Thank you for showing up. And thank you for always being willing to do good and to share Christ with people today. Would you pray with me? God, I think about all of these different people, and what's so cool about today is in 14 years, I don't hardly ever get to see them in the light. So, man, they're some good-looking people, Lord. You did good. But what I'm reminded of as I see these faces is all of the stories of people that have given and sacrificed. I also am reminded of the different stories that maybe that they were going through when they were overcoming cancer or battling cancer or the loss of a child. And it would have been easy to lay down and quit, but they didn't because they really did live out what we just walked through. Lord, we know there's going to be trouble, but may we have you on our side. God, and when we not only have you, God, you put people around us to help us get through it. Lord, help us to understand those simple principles. Run to you and run to the people around us. Don't give up because nothing will ever separate us from your love. In the middle of all the brokenness, God, let it be a beautiful thing for us to be present, to be in the moment, to meet the need, to serve the way that you call us to serve, to run into the tragedy, not away from it, like our first responders, like our doctors and our nurses, our hospital staffs. Help us, God, to be like the janitors, God, that would go in and clean up the mess that nobody else wants to clean up. Help us to be a servant the way that you called us to be a servant. Let us be known for solving problems, God, in a way that most people would never want to get involved in. And I thank you, Jesus, that over 14 years we've had the privilege to get to do that together. I'm honored to be a part of it. Help us, God. Whatever's ahead and whatever we're going through, that we would continue to be your light, we would continue to lean on you, and we would continue to share you with the people that need you the most. If there's somebody, God, that's never given their life to you, God, it's not about walking an aisle, signing a card, it's really about surrender. Maybe today someone would say, Jesus, I just need you, man. I don't understand it all, but I'm broke, I'm hurt. And then, God, I pray you'd meet them right where they're at. You know in their heart how much you love them, that they can just receive the free gift. All they have to do is what I do every day. Continue, God. I know I'm a sinner, and I ask you just to forgive me, God. I want you to come into my life, and I want you to help me as I take these steps forward. God, as we do that together, let us encourage each other in that journey. Over 50 examples in your scripture right there. Help us, God, to live it out on this planet. Thank you, Jesus, for who you are and for what you're doing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can I get an amen somewhere? Come on, one time.